What's up, guys? EpicConspiracy here. Today's video is going to be a little bit different. I've kind of been wanting to make a video about this for a while, but I always thought it would be corny. You know, I look like a dumbass or something. You know, my wife told me. Yeah, probably not, because it'd make me look stupid or something. But to start things off, we moved into this house about 5 years ago, and we've noticed that, like, weird stuff has happened around the house. I mean, it's not, like, anything big, but just, like, little weird stuff has happened. Like stuff we'll put somewhere and it'll disappear, like our car keys or, you know, our wallet or just weird stuff. And it's like, where is it? We'll look everywhere for it, you know, and we'll give up, grab another set of keys or something. We'll come back and they'll be right there where we left it, or they'll be on the floor. It's weird. Like, we'll turn the lights off upstairs and, you know, we'll come back a little later and the lights will be back on. There's just, like, really weird stuff that happens in this house. And, you know, it's funny. It's like an inside joke between me and my wife. We actually call, like, whatever's messing with us Hurley. Hurley the ghost. But it's been happening a lot more often recently, like in the last 6 months or so, which has been pretty weird. And what really made me to start, I want to start videotaping, you know. Like, I was a big Paranormal Activity fan, and I was like, you know, hey, I'm going to set up cameras and record, you know, all the time around here. So I went and bought a bunch of big memory sticks and stuff so I can just start recording. I got another camera so I can just record and maybe, you know, catch something weird on camera. But, you know, so I figured I'd start a new little series here, The True Life Paranormal Activity, The True Life Real Story with EpicConspiracy. Now, what set me off to make me do this was, a couple nights ago, I was laying in bed, I was sleeping, and I kind of woke up, and I opened my eyes, and I saw, like, shadow go out of my room, so I thought my wife got up, and I woke up, you know, to get something to drink or something, go to the bathroom, whatever. Then I hear footsteps going upstairs, and I was thinking to myself, I wonder why she's doing going upstairs. I don't know. So I closed my eyes and I stretched out, and my foot hit her foot, and I looked over, and she's sitting right next to me. And my two dogs are in the room; they were asleep. So, you know, I instantly got up. I'm like, what the fuck is going on? What was that? So I went upstairs, and, you know, there's no one in the house or anything. So I'm like, this is weird. I'm going to start videotaping this shit and start, you know, talking about, like, the weird stuff that's going on. This isn't an exaggeration. This isn't a lie. I mean, this is real weird shit that's happened. I guess you could explain a lot of it. Maybe the keys get knocked off of the table. Maybe the cat knocked them off, or, you know, I mean, I'm sure it's all explainable, but there's just some weird stuff going on. So then I started looking back at the history of the house. Who lived here before us. The house was built in 1950. The original owners lived here until 1971, and second owners bought it and lived here until 1980. And then a couple bought the house in 1980, and they sold it in 92, which was weird. And I did a little bit of research on them, and it was a husband and a wife and two kids. And the wife and the two kids went missing. And they never did found them, so the husband sold the house and moved away. And as far as I know, that was the end of it, that they never found them, which is kind of weird. Now, yes, that gets kind of freaky. Now, after that, no one's lived in this house for more than 3 years. I mean, like, it was sold 3 years, year, 2 years. When we looked at it, we just looked at the last owner, how much he paid for it. So, very, very, very weird. And, you know, I have, like, the past, like, 3-4 owners' names and phone numbers now, so I plan on calling them and seeing if I can get any info. Like, why did they sell the house so fast? You know, hopefully I'm going to try to see if they'll let me, like, record talking to them if they see anything weird, which would be pretty cool. But I'm just going to take you around and show, like, the house and show you, like, some of the weird stuff that's happened. Here's, like, my living room. There's my TV. Now, that's another, there's a few weird things that happen, and it seems to be pretty consistent. Lights getting turned on. Yeah, not really off, they just get turned on when I, you know, after I turn them off. TVs getting turned on. Like, it's stuff getting turned on, which is really weird. like our keys, like I told you, the keys get knocked off the table. I usually throw my car keys on the table like here, and sometimes they'll just be down on the, I'll come in and they'll be down on the floor like that, and it's really weird. Now, the weirdest time it ever happened, I was watching TV in there, and I ordered a pizza, and I came in to get my keys, and they were on the floor, and I was here the whole time, and I never heard them hit the floor, which was the weirdest thing. Here's like my upstairs where I heard the footsteps go up the other day. I just heard steps just like that, like they were kind of running up the steps. It wasn't real slow, but I didn't hear any doors close or anything, which is real weird. Like here's a little attic thing. And this is the weirdest thing of all. This is by far the weirdest thing that happens. This only happens in my closet here. Let me get a flashlight so you can see better. This is my closet. Like once a week, I'll come in and some of my clothes will be down on the floor off the hanger. See, I'm real weird. I hang like everything up, like all my t-shirts and stuff, and I'll just have like a random couple things on the floor. I guess they could have fell off the hanger, but I mean, they're shirts that, I mean, they're not just gonna fall off the hanger. It's just, it's weird. And then there's one other thing. We'll go outside to my garage, because it happens outside in my garage. Gotta get it open here. Hopefully it's not still raining so I don't get all wet. Yeah, this weird stuff happens outside my garage, too. Go out here. It's my truck. Right here, I have my smoker in the garage. Now, I keep it closed. Now, every so often, I'll come out here, and it'll be open like that. It's really freaking weird. You know, like the smoker will just be open. You know, and I'll close it again, and I guarantee to you, I'll come out here, because I don't get in my garage a lot, especially in the wintertime. I'll come out here in a week, and that motherfucker will be open. And I thought my wife was fucking with me for a while, but, you know, she swears. It's not her, she isn't. Oh, it's still raining. It's good. Get in here out of the rain. So, I mean, that's just some of the weird stuff that happens right there. Let me put it back on here. And that's, yeah, that there, you know, like I just showed you, it's really weird. And, I mean, I guess it could be a big coincidence. Cat knock, you know, like I said, the cat knocking the keys off, you know. I don't know. My garage is locked. There's no way to get in it. Nobody goes in it but me. I don't know how that would get flipped up, like the clothes. It's just really, it's weird stuff. Like, you know, I don't feel like I'm in danger anyway, but it's just very weird. And I'm anxious to get in contact with people that lived in here before to find out why they all moved. Because I talked to a couple of the neighbors, and they have said that when they were talking to moving, they gave like vague answers. Even the one where they're still friends with, they gave them like a vague answer, like they found a better deal or something. But they always thought something weird was going on. So I'm gonna keep putting videos up. You know, it's pretty interesting. If you've ever had any weird stuff happen to you, you know, leave a comment. Tell me, you know, what happened, because I'd be interested to hear other stories too. But until next time, guys, it's Epic Conspiracy signing out.